This is the main argument, and my main argument to use zirconia implants. If you see these healthy tissue around these implants, this is really fun. And you can say, yes, on a Congress, he's picking out the best pictures on it. And I can tell you, no, that's not a fact. So it's every time the same situation around that. And this makes me happy. And so we can say, yes, we have a lot of advantages for ceramic implants. We have the better aesthetics of gray shining we discussed. We have less plaque. We have less inflammation. We have maybe less peri-implantitis, a better blood circulation, and maybe no foreign body reaction around this kind of implants. And these, we have seen some preclinical data for that, but this is also, we need more clinical, long-term evidence for that, but this is what we can observe with our clinical observation.
That's actually something that we also see in our studies. We're now focusing, even though we are looking at things from the prosthodontic side, also on material integration, soft tissue integration, bacterial integration. It's become so important, and this is why we truly believe that, you know, this data is exactly what it is, because we have the same findings. But let's look at the clinical side of things as well. Michael, can you give us some ideas? There are few people in the world who have as much, I would say, you know, experience with zirconia implants as you have, so please enlighten us with your clinical observations.
Yeah, the tissue potential of ceramic implants are enormous. Every implantologist is afraid of these recessions when we make an implant and we have a bone deficit. Also, when we build up the bone in the high aesthetic area, we often have the problem that then a little piece of tissue is missing, and then we have a compromised solution here in the aesthetic area. Here in this case, we lost a lot of bone. We built a bone up. We used a ceramic implant. And then after that, we make a provisional crown from the lab to create this red aesthetic, to create the soft tissue. And when you see it on this side, it's the moment when you bring in the provisional tools from the lab. You have a little bit of anemone, but then you can create this. And don't forget, this is plastic. This is not ceramic. Yeah? And we saw this effect that then after a while, in the moment you create the final tooth, then here we have the new carbon screw with in combination with this noble pearl ceramic implant. So this means you can have absolutely metal-free rehabilitation here. And you have the same effect in the moment you bring it in. You have this anemic zone. And now, if you believe it me or not, this is very typical of these ceramic implants, that then the tissue is coming down. And this effect we saw at many, many cases. And here, because you have a very nice material, we have this seems to be this is the Wielander study. He gave us evidence that we have phenomenal tissue effects when we use the ceramic implants.
So I mean, we will go back a little bit. What I really think about some of the, you know, zirconia implants, some of them have been on the market and not and come off the market. I think we learned quite a bit about what we should be, you know, paying attention towards when we look at these zirconia implants. But maybe before we talk about the specifics of that system, why don't we go back and have a better understanding? Why do we see better mucosa? Why do we see healthier tissue? Maybe, you know, Jens, if you can enlighten us with that.
Yeah, I think so. I think it's a question of the material. And now don't be shocked. Yes, I consider both materials are metals. So we have the titanium and the zirconium at the start, and we call it zirconium as a metal. This is the origin of that. But with oxygen, we get an oxidation, and then it changed. So we talked already about this. With titanium, we have the preservation layer, titanium dioxide, and zirconia is oxidated to zirconia, we call it now, or zirconium dioxide in this case. And we see no more metal ions inside the zirconium dioxide ion.
By the way, it's this is actually, I always get this question. It drives me crazy that, you know, every time somebody comes up, you know, you're more, or zirconia is a metal, so we can do everything
exactly.
with the metal. It drives me crazy because it's total nonsense. Where does it come from?
This is what the reason why I show you that, because
exactly.
we have to clear
I really
this
appreciate
this.
That.
And mostly important is to know that this process, metal and then oxygen, is ceramic. It's chemical.
Exactly.
That's basic knowledge. And it's not a reversible process. So we can't come back to the zirconia ions or the metal ions. So we have to finish this. It's a ceramic, and titanium is a titanium. But it's interesting. So our titanium passivation layer is per se also a ceramic.
Yes.
And that is the reason why a titanium implant works. And we have to know that. But inside the titanium, in the core of the titanium, we have still the metal, so we have the free electrons. And we don't have this with the zirconia. We have the covalent true connections and a really low reactivity because of this covalent reactions connections. And this causes this nice behavior of this material. And this causes also this poor thermal and electrical conductivity of zirconia.
Can we just clarify that again? So, because there's staunch differences between a ceramic and a metal. The titanium dioxide can be called a ceramic because it has this oxide layer on top of it. On the inside, it's still the same. And metals have the ability to undergo plastic deformation. That is the big difference. Whereas the zirconium dioxide is a crystalline structure, so it cannot undergo plastic deformation. That means we're talking about two totally different things. And that's why we have to be very careful when we compare the two.
Definitely. And this is the most important thing if we are talking about the connection of abutment. For example,
exactly.
prosthetic restoration. With titanium, I can use the concepts because I have the elasticity inside. We have to think in ceramic if we go to ceramic concept. We'll see a little bit later also for
Absolutely.
That. So, but for me, important also for our clinical use is the poor thermal conductivity of the material. Because if we drill a hole for an implant, then we create heat inside the bone. And we know if it's becoming too hot inside the bone, it comes to bone destruction and disruption in the bone regeneration. So we're cooling or slow, like with a new N1 with 50 turns around per minute, slowly. Yeah. But this is a drilling. That is not a problem. The problem is inserting the implant. Because if I insert my implant, I produce heat. It's not self-cutting implants. And it's a very, not a sharp surface on it, so it's very stumped. And it's producing heat inside the bone. And titanium implant would take the heat out, but we have no thermal conductivity. And this may lead to overheating inside the bone and the problems. And this could be the problems in the past. If you lost the implant, could turn it around, however. This was a learning curve for us. And also in this case, please use every time the thread cutter. Pre-cut the thread and every time on the full length, and then insert the implant by hand. That's quite easy in the last two threads. It's becoming the primary stability. It feels a little bit different than a titanium implant. And this is a case to that. And this was a patient. He was sent to me to treat this peri-implantitis around this zirconia implant. I was a little bit wondering because I never seen before at peri-implantitis. We have to differentiate. For cementitis, maybe if one piece implant, however. I've never seen a peri-implantitis. And I asked, please send me the picture before. And this is a picture, 3 months post-surgery before loading. And look at this. We have here. This is a typical heating defect. This was overheating, too much pressure while inserting. But look what happened in the 2 years without any treatment. I've never seen with a titanium implant coming the bone back like that.
But see, this is, I think, we are made the biggest mistakes when we started with zirconia implants many years back, because we just treated it like as a titanium implant.
That's
and you cannot. You have to learn from that.